Picture this. You've traveled back in time, and you're a teenager again. You're sitting in health class, and whichever teacher they manage to rope into this pulls out a banana and a condom and says, "Here it is, your sex ed class." Now, chances are, whatever followed probably wasn't a super comprehensive overview of the latest sexuality science, and teenage you might have been left scratching your head about many aspects of sexuality. Now, non-comprehensive sex education is just one of the many ways that people fail to receive information or even receive misinformation about sexuality. But why is this important? Well, previous research suggests that holding accurate beliefs about sexuality is important for our sexual outcomes. So if people hold inaccurate beliefs about sexuality, they could be at risk for sexual problems. Identifying who is most at risk for holding inaccurate beliefs about sexuality is key so that sex researchers can target our interventions to the people who need them the most. So for my master's thesis, I wanted to understand who is most likely to endorse myths about sexuality and to examine how endorsing myths about sexuality impacts sexual outcomes. So in my study, 4,428 people completed an online survey where they reported on a range of their demographic information. Next, participants rated their agreement with a range of statements about sexuality. But unbeknownst to participants, these statements were actually myths about sexuality, like masturbation is unhealthy or orgasm equals good sex. Lastly, participants reported on their sexual satisfaction, relationship satisfaction, and sexual distress. We found that being assigned male at birth, identifying as cisgender, identifying as heterosexual, holding more conservative political views, being more religious, and having ever taken a human sexuality course in college all significantly predicted greater endorsement of sexuality myths. Next, we found that endorsing greater sexuality myths was a significant predictor of lower sexual satisfaction, lower relationship satisfaction, and higher sexual distress. So what does this all mean? Well, this study is the first to identify which demographic factors are most relevant to holding inaccurate beliefs about sexuality. And the findings from this study will allow sex researchers to target our knowledge translation initiatives to the people most at risk of holding beliefs that could be detrimental for their sexual outcomes. Ultimately, it's key for sex researchers to continue battling myth understandings about sexuality in order to promote a more evidence-based approach to sexuality within society, instead of a banana and condom approach alone. Thank you so much.